Are you planning on relocating to Canada with your family? Then this video is for you. Hello everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Those of you who are new here, welcome. My name is Gifty and I am super excited to have you here. The long-awaited video is here. Thank you very much for the subscription so far, guys. I really appreciate. God bless you all. Let's still keep this
recently fun. Many of you have been reaching out to me asking me about the pathways that I used in landing in Canada.
I decided to use this as an opportunity to share with you my journey and also give you a valuable insight about how you can also plan your trip. Before I start, I want to clarify that I am not an immigration consultant. Everything that I am sharing with you is based on my personal experience and the researches that I have made so far. Let's jump into the video. I mentioned that there are so many pathways in landing yourself in Canada. You can use the visiting pathway, you can use the study pathway, you can come through express entry, you can come through work permit, and a lot. But today, we will talk about relocating to Canada through the study pathway. We will start with the benefits. Somebody will ask, what are even the benefits of me traveling to Canada? Okay, so traveling to Canada as a student, one, you have the opportunity to bring your spouse with you. Two, you can bring your common law partner. When we say a common law partner, means somebody that you are into a relationship with, but it is not legally signed in law. You can bring your kids with you as well. And also, being a student in Canada, you have the opportunity to work part-time whilst your spouse work full-time. And also, you can apply for your permanent residency after your studies as well, or your spouse can even. So for you to start the school application, you have to first of all get your document. The document you will need to start your school application is, one, you will need your passport. Two, you will need your certificates. Okay. Three, you will need your transcripts. Four, you will need a CV. So these are the things basically you will need to apply for school in Canada. You don't need any agent to help you in this. You don't need any IELTS in this. It depends on the school that you want to apply or the program that you want to apply. If you want to apply for 1 year program or 2 years, that one depends on you. But the details is that if you apply for 2 years, you have 3 years postgraduate work permits. And if you apply for 1 year program, you have 1 year postgraduate work permits. Postgraduate work permits means that working after your studies. Okay, so if you pursue 2 year program, you have 3 years to work after your study. But if you pursue 1 year program, you have 1 year to work after your study. All right, so right now that we have gotten all our documents, what is next for us to do? The next thing to do is that you have to scan all these documents, okay, and save it on your laptop or on your phone. So
what you have to do is that you will come to Google, you type DLI in Canada, okay? So it will give you the designated learning institution in Canada, meaning the school is registered. That is what you have to always look at. So we will click the first one, and then we search through the Canada government website, okay? So this is the list of designated learning institutions. Then you choose the province that you want to apply your school. We choose Ontario for this. We go through all schools in Ontario. We check for whether the school is designated learning institution and if they offer postgraduate work permit. So the designated learning institution is the numbers there. And the postgraduate work permit is the yes and no there. So these are the two things that you have to check before you apply for school. Because if you apply for school and they are not DLI and they failed to offer you postgraduate work permit, then there wasn't any benefit in your travel. Okay.
One thing that I want to also clarify is that before you search for school, you have to look for two things. Does the school give postgraduate work permits for that your program that you are selecting? Is the school registered? Like, is the school a designated learning institution? You have to check for this before you apply for the school. When you go to the school website, what you will see is that you will go through their admission requirements, admission process, application process, and everything about the school. You have to make sure that you look at the tuition fee. Have to make sure that if they are taking a deposit, looking at your finances, are they taking a deposit or are they taking the full tuition fee, so that you know what you want and you decide. Okay, so when you go through their website, all what you have to do is that just click on apply. After you've searched through everything, click on apply. Then you just go through whatever options they are giving you, your name, your passport number, your date of birth, whatever that they are asking you there. Then you select your programs that you want, and that you would upload your documents and you apply. The only thing you do is that they take application fee, which is like $100 Canadian. Okay, so when you apply, what next? You have to just wait for the school to respond. When you get this document, you are done with the school. What you have to do is that you have to move to your visa application. If this video has been useful as at this point, please just like the video for me. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe, because I am bringing you a lot of information. Okay, talk about the documents needed for the visa application. One, to apply for your visa, you will need one, your police clearance. Two, you will need your passport. Three, you would need your proof of finance. This is the most important thing, your proof of finance. Then three, you need your home tie. What is home tie? Home tie is something that you want the visa officer to know that when you come to Canada, this is what is binding you back to your country. Okay, so that is your home tie. So it is any asset that you have. If you are married, you can use your husband. If you have kids, you can use them. If you have a land, if you have a car or any property that you have, you can use that as a proof of finance. A business or whatever, you can use it as a proof of finance. So you just need documents from these things. All these documents, what you need again is the letter of acceptance that the school gave to you. Then your tuition deposit that you made, the receipt. You add all the certificates you use in applying for your school. Okay, your school application, that is your transcripts and your certificates and your CV. And with all these documents, you will write everything in what we call statement of purpose, SOP, statement of purpose. This is what the visa officer will read to grant you the success of your visa. So the statement of purpose is something which is very, very important, and I'll bring you guidelines on how to write your SOP, your statement of purpose, reason for applying for the school or that course, why you want to come to Canada, how much you have, like your proof of fund, how much do you have, and also your home ties. What are your home ties? So you put everything in a writing form. That is the SOP. Okay, basically these are the documents we need for our visa application. You don't need any help from anybody to do this. When you get these documents, all what you have to do is that you just go to Google again, you type GCK, you will just find it on Google. You click it and you start with your visa application. You fill forms, then you upload all your documents and you pay your visa application fee, and that is all. You are done. So I would also bring you video on how to apply for your visa, how to apply for your school, okay? Through OCAS, we have OCAS that are schools in Ontario, or you can also go to the individual school website to search for the school. I'll bring you videos about all these things. If you apply for your visa, it will take you like 2 to 3 months for you to get your visa. First, they will call you for your biometric, they'll call you for your medicals. Guys, if they call you for your medicals, then you will start with the joy. You start with the joy, start packing your things. If you pass, then you are done. You go and submit your passport for stamping, guys. You plan your plane ticket, then here you are in Canada. So basically, this is how to land yourself in Canada through the study pathway. First, gather your documents that I mentioned. Second, start with the school search, apply for the school, wait for their response, pay for the deposit, then move on with your visa application. Then lastly, the most important thing is to add prayers, guys. Add prayers. So if this video has been useful to you so far, please continue to turn the notification bell so that the next video that I am bringing, you would benefit from it. What I would say is that if you have any question, leave it in the comment section down there. And also, I have a WhatsApp group. If the information is so sensitive that you cannot bring it out to the public, kindly join my WhatsApp group, share your ideas, and also ask your question. I will do my possible best to reply and help you with your answer. Thank you very much for watching. I hope this video has been useful so far. Thank you very much. Bye bye. I can see that you were watching.